Welcome back to Robinson Foundry. Most people look at styrofoam cups as, well, styrofoam cups and nothing more. When I look at them, I can't help but wonder if it would be possible to turn them into metal using a method called lost foam casting. In its most basic form, this is a method where a styrofoam object is buried in sand and molten metal is poured onto it, instantly vaporizing the foam and taking its shape. I demonstrated this recently by casting the most useless objects in the world, solid aluminum packing peanuts. The challenge with these cups is that the walls are so thin and the metal has to travel all the way down before solidifying. Well, I'm always up for a challenge, so let's see if this can actually be done. This is drywall joint compound. I used something similar to coat the styrofoam packing peanuts, and it worked really well, so I thought I'd try it again. Before I started coating the cups with this stuff, I had to make sure that it was unaffected by acetone. I simply allowed a small amount to dry in the sun before pouring a little acetone onto it and checking to see if any of it dissolved away. I diluted the joint compound in water and then slowly built up a thick layer on the cups over the course of about a week. And to increase my chances of ending up with a successful casting, I made a bunch of these. Here's where the acetone comes in. I used it to dissolve away the bulk of the styrofoam, which I was hoping would allow the metal to flow all the way down into the mold. I made sure to allow the acetone to completely evaporate before attempting to cast these. I filled the inside of these molds in vermiculite and then buried them in sand. First up was aluminum. I expected a little fire and bubbling from any remaining styrofoam, but definitely not this much. Well, as you can see, there was just too much styrofoam left inside the molds, which prevented the metal from flowing, and it caused a lot of porosity in the castings. At this point, I was definitely a little bit discouraged, but I decided to try again with pewter, which has a much lower melting point. Surprisingly, this actually worked extremely well, and the cups completely filled out. After cleaning off as much joint compound as I could, I noticed that in a few small spots, the surface finish was actually perfect. However, on the rest of the castings, the joint compound ended up leaving behind a very thin layer on the surface, and that was extremely difficult to remove. I ended up just using a sandblaster, which still took quite a while. After sandblasting, I used my milling machine to remove what was left over of the sprues and then shine them up with a Scotch-Brite wheel. I thought this was an interesting experiment that ended up being moderately successful. Attempting to cast such thin-walled objects like these cups is really asking a lot of this method, but I think this experiment demonstrated the possibilities of lost foam casting. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this little experiment, and if you did, please let me know what you think in the comments, give the video a thumbs up, and subscribe for future videos. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.